welcome to the official Tottenham Hotspur video of the season 1990-1991. As the opening day approached, the 1990-1991 season was full of expectation for fans, players and manager Terry Venables.
This is the part of the football season that I love, because everybody's thinking of winning championships, everyone's thinking of winning the cup, nobody's kicked a ball in anger yet, but now Terry Venables, what news have you for us? Do you think you're going to do well?
If you think you love it, that's what we certainly love, because we're not in trouble yet. But I know what you mean. It is a time when everyone's friends, and once the ball starts getting kicked off, we have a few more problems. But we're optimistic. We know we've got a good football inside. We have had a few problems defensively last season, but we think we can get over those, and we've got to get over those if we're going to be challenging for the league.
Well, we've had a very good pre-season. I think everybody's been talking about us after the end of last season. We had a tremendous finish and coming up third, and I think everyone was pleased with that, especially at the club and the supporters. But we've got to try and go on from there now and try and use that as a stepping stone. And we've been building on it pre-season. We've had a lot of friendlies. We've had 10 friendlies now already and in a sort of a four-week period. So it's been quite a hectic schedule for us, but it's gone very well and the team's looking in good shape. And as you say, the squad itself is pretty similar to last season. We've had no real major signings in the summer that's going to change the side too much. So we're looking forward to it, and hopefully we're ready to go for Saturday.
A festival atmosphere then at White Hart Lane, as the same 11 who finished last season started this with the reputations of Gary Lineker and Paul Gascoigne, further enhanced by Italian 90. The match a sellout with a worldwide television audience in over 60 countries.
Paul Lake playing alongside Colin Hendry in the centre of City's defence. It came off, but Lake's head, Lineker! Just 2 minutes. And it's as though he's never been away. The leading scorer in the first division last season, Paul Lake miscalculated. Colin Hendry was slow to react. Not so Lineker. 1-0 Tottenham. Just the script that Lineker would have loved to have written himself. That's misjudgment by Bergson. This is Mark Ward for Manchester City. Reid. Brightwell playing at right back. And it's a good cross for Quinn! Delivered by David White. Met by Niall Quinn. Manchester City not disheartened, letting Lineker score first here.
Spurs had the right inclination. A free kick signalled by the linesman for a two-footed tackle or challenge by Mark Ward. But the referee didn't take any notice. And wave play on. Tottenham won't be too happy if this ends in a goal. And it still could. Quinn! Now he's ruled it out. There's some pushing in there by Quinn. Stuart Lineker. Yes, on goes Stuart. Can he wrap it up now? It would have been an outstanding goal in the first half on the first day of the season. At times the ball was just behind the pair of them, but they kept it going, improvising, some instinctive work. And then a head-down charge for goal by Stewart. But he just couldn't get there. Step by Sedgley. Stewart. That's the most accomplished manner. And this is Naeem. Lineker cutting in from the left. And Naeem has found him brilliantly! Salutes almost as if he was the scorer, and Lineker went to him as well. Manchester City simply melted away front of Naim here, and Lineker timed the run to dictate the pass, which was weighted splendidly. The finish looked academic, but that's the way Lineker is. It was a spellbinding goal, and there was nothing that Curtin could do about it. But Samway's caught out. Oh, and Hendry, when he had Heath to his right, not taking full advantage and sparing the blushes of Vinnie Samways. Loitering on the left, and he scored the goal. The player who's filled the ground, really, and he's turned their dreams into reality here, and in doing so presumably killed off Manchester City, who neglected him in the first place. And remember, they've switched Hendry upfield. Harper in the back line couldn't stop Gascoigne going on. And the shot was low and true. And the headline writers here are going to have a field day.
Yes, a great start to the season and an encouraging first away match, a goalless draw at Sunderland. Next, the local derby against Arsenal at Highbury.
It's always tough between these two, as this challenge on Tottenham's Paul Stewart by Tony Adams illustrates. Adams going into Joe Worrall's book in the first minute. It was left to you-know-who to provide the best moment of the first half. Gascoigne's curling free kick going just past the post. And this from a position which had proved so profitable for Gazza in Italy. The referee was called upon once again after everyone at Highbury wearing red thought the Gunners should have had a penalty. Following some neat interplay, Paul Davis fell spectacularly in the box. Mr. Worrall wasn't buying the theatricals though, so nothing doing, and in the end, Spurs and Paul Gascoigne, who was substituted by Terry Venables, had to settle for their second goalless draw of the week.
14 minutes gone, and watch for a sweet pass from Naheem to Lineker. Gascoigne up in support, and Peter Shilton might not be very happy with the way that ball slipped through his fingers. But Gazza certainly saved a great performance for his former manager at Newcastle, Arthur Cox. Two splendid free kicks. Into the top corner after a beautiful dummy. And now the hat-trick late in the game from even further out, and this really is a special effort from Paul Gascoigne, beating Shilton from distance. Spurs unbeaten this season and undefeated at White Hart Lane since early March.
Chapman and Torsvet kept it out only just. Sure that visiting teams will also appreciate playing in the stadium, which has had great occasions here in the past. And Strachan trying to give us a great occasion here. Gary Speed is free, and he's wide. Great turn by Berardi. Oh, it came to Chris Wade, a misjudgment by Van den Hal. Strachan shoots, and Torsvet catches it almost casually. Whitlow. Good harassing from Spurs again, and it's Stewart who plays it through. Lukic has hesitated, and Howells gets it through the goalkeeper, and Tottenham do have the lead now. And really, it was coming over the last 5 minutes or so. Leeds haven't been able to recapture
the commitment of their first half display. And Paul Stewart provided the pass over the top of Fairclough. Howells hit it first time, and Lukic will be disappointed that it got past him. Plenty of strength, but having made the save, a more difficult save from Stewart. It's a goal now, but Varane can equalise, and has done! Well, it's been a match that has threatened this, but it's been disallowed. Well, Varane wriggled his way into that position. It was Mel Stirland who hit the long ball forward, and I can only think that there was a push there by Varane on Gary Mabbutt that the referee took exception to, and it's no goal. Tottenham still have the lead, and they're looking to add to it. And Stewart and Lineker, it's 2-0. It might have been 1-1, Leeds feel it should have been 1-1. An extraordinary chapter of events. And Leeds feel that they've had the rug tugged from beneath their feet. Lineker on hand, Stewart involved as he was in the first goal. And I think from the Leeds point of view, it's a case of we've got nothing to lose, but maybe they've got another goal to lose. Lineker in behind Stirland. There's two in the centre. Gascoigne, oh, goodness me! It was almost the ultimate in open goals. And even the best can miss, but Lineker looked up and put it on a plate for Gascoigne. My word.
Three more points and Spurs remain undefeated, along with Liverpool, Arsenal and Crystal Palace, and only one goal conceded.
It has been going well for us, and I think now in the recent, well, four, five games, all the games here we've played, I think we've looked quite solid in defence, and I'm not meaning the the back four. I think it's just all over the team. And we're doing well at the moment, just hopefully we can keep that going.
Now, I've noticed Eric seems to be almost a captain of the defence, doesn't he? He's very positive in everything he does behind you.
Yes, that's true. He has been playing tremendously for us, and he really sort of owns the box now, and he's taking those difficult crosses that are maybe a bit difficult for us, the back four, and he's coming out there and he's really demanding in all his actions.
It's been a great start to the season. What, just one goal conceded, and now we've got three home matches on the trot in eight days. So yes. Who knows, in about a week's time?
Yes, who knows, but well, we're a bit sceptical about starting to think about records, because when you start to do that, maybe, you know, you think about, well, next 50 minutes, next 90 minutes for the record. But if we play to our ability and we're a bit lucky as well, I think we could still be with a clean sheet for the next three games, hopefully.
Eric Torsved, 444 minutes, and you haven't conceded a goal since that one that went in against Manchester City at the 6th minute.
Yeah, that's right. When they scored that early in the game against Manchester City, I thought, like, here we go again. But after that, it stopped, so it's a good thing, really.
The next visitors to White Hart Lane, another unbeaten team, Crystal Palace.
For the first 43 minutes, the sellout crowd at White Hart Lane got a game littered with fouls. Palace disputed this one vehemently, but a free kick it was. England assistant manager Laurie McMenemy needs little reminding of a certain gentleman's prowess from dead ball situations. Paul Gascoigne, number 8. Goal number 5 for him, and Spurs in control. referee, perhaps in the way of the defensive wall. Nigel Martin in goal claimed he wasn't ready. But Palace fought back well in the second half. A great ball from Geoff Thomas there, and England hopeful Ian Wright, well, really should have done a lot better. But Wright soon made amends. Some fine work from him here. And skipper Geoff Thomas was on the spot for a fully deserved equaliser. Spurs still unbeaten and having their best start for years, could have wrapped up the 3 points. But there's a rare miss from Lineker. Stewart faltered in front of goal. And there's the Lineker miss.
A point apiece and Manchester United leapfrog over Tottenham and Palace with a 3-2 win against Southampton. Next came the first of the cup competitions, the Rumbelows League Cup, and the first Spurs team change of the season, with Justin Edinburgh taking over the number two jersey from Gudni Bergsson. The visitors, Hartlepool.
Hartlepool never met Spurs before. What will their memories be? This is Stewart into the middle for Lineker! And that's the first goal! Spurs, Walsh, Vandenhout. He's got Walsh running ahead of him. Lineker, Gascoigne. Now Gascoigne, yes! 3-0. A brilliant goal from Paul Gascoigne once again. So much time, it's magnificent to watch. Gascoigne, here he goes again. Oh, there he goes again. Is he going to do it all the way? He goes over, and that's another penalty. Well, I'll give you two guesses who's going to take this one. Gazza's on a hat-trick. He clearly said to Lineker there, shall I have a go with this? He didn't take a penalty in the World Cup shootout against West Germany. Going to take one now. Lineker's missed already this evening. It's up to Gazza. This for the hat-trick. It was never going to go anywhere but in the net. I feel for Hartlepool, really. They're still coming forward there. Look at that, but they're cut out at every turn. Again, the long, flowing football that we know and love so well. Here's Lineker. Across for Gascoigne. It's number five. So unselfish from Gary Lineker. So simple from Paul Gascoigne.
2 weeks later, the return leg, a formality. Tottenham running out 2-1 winners on the night, 7-1 on aggregate. Back to the league and the next visitors, Aston Villa, runners-up in the Championship the previous season.
Cowan's with the free kick. Platt! What a magnificent goal by David Platt! His seventh goal of the season. And so far, in the battle between England's two brightest stars, David Platt is most definitely ahead. Lineker. Rich Shadder handball from the Villa fans behind that goal. And Allen just run out of room. Platt turned away and realised he couldn't go back to Spink because Gascoigne was between the two of them and has had to concede the corner. That's a good kick as well, and Mabbott climbed highest of all. The stroke of half-time, Gary Lineker's opportunism has brought Spurs level. He's most anxious though, because I think it's Howells who went crashing down in the build-up to that. He must have fallen very heavily onto his shoulder, I think. But Spurs have drawn level in the dying seconds of the first half. And it was the finishing, as ever, of Gary Lineker that produced the goal. The corner, following Platt's mistake, magnificent header by Mabbott, which smashed against the crossbar. Cowans couldn't keep it out, and who else but Gary Lineker anticipating ahead of anyone else. And Cowans finds Daly, and suddenly a huge space has opened up in the middle of the field for Villa. Good challenge by Mabbott, but Platt takes on and beats Thomas. Or does he? He doesn't. Mitchell Thomas did well. And Walsh for Spurs. On to Allen, and Allen's in the clear. Yes! Paul Allen gets his first goal of the season, and Tottenham are in front. 9 minutes to go, Spink beaten, and a splendid piece of finishing by Paul Allen. And cool as you like into the corner of the net.
Spurs maintain their impressive away form in an entertaining London derby at Loftus Road. Both sides had chances to win the game. Fine save from Tony Roberts, avoiding embarrassment for Paul Parker. Former England skipper Ray Wilkins could have put Rangers in front, but was denied by a fine save from Eric Portsmead. You can see why Spurs have gone 360 minutes without conceding an away goal. In the second half, Portsmead denied Rangers once more. A poor backheader from Howells. Les Ferdinand disappointed he didn't put the rebound away. Paul Gascoigne might have done better from an excellent through ball played by Paul Allen. But Paul Parker pressured him all the way. No goals then, but no shortage of action.
Paul Gascoigne and Gary Lineker both played in England's European Championship qualifying game against Poland, Lineker scoring before receiving a bad cut on the head requiring stitches. So he was on the substitutes bench as Sheffield United came to White Hart Lane.
Tottenham are making headlines before the game after the Stock Exchange suspended dealings in the club's shares. To make matters worse, England captain Gary Lineker was replaced by Paul Walsh after sustaining a head injury in the international against Poland. It didn't matter. Walsh proved to be more than a handful for Dave Bassett's side. Walsh forcing home his first goal after David Howell's header came back off the bar. Sheffield's misery increased in a moment of madness. Fullback David Barnes deliberately struck the ball against the linesman. And Barnes receiving the red card for a second bookable offence. Sheffield's 10 men overrun now. And Naheem continued his fine form this season by adding a second goal minutes later. Fine through ball from Walsh. Fine finish from the Spanish midfield man. And all this happened in the second half. Spurs on their way to their biggest league win of the season. Before today, Paul Walsh hadn't managed a goal. but he tormented the Sheffield defenders. Sheffield all at sea as Walsh jinks in once again. And he wasn't finished yet. Closing moments now, and the Walsh hat-trick from Paul Stewart. And Walsh in to beat Simon Tracy. Four more goals for Spurs. They remain unbeaten and keep the pressure on Arsenal and Liverpool at the top of the table.
Gascoigne slipped keen impeccably. And it's opened up, and Gascoigne very nearly produced the perfect goal. Well, Nottingham Forest had players there, you'll see that, but they just couldn't stop him. In the end, they did distract him. But it was a run of wonderful skill and imagination, and it very nearly tilted the early stages Tottenham's way. Jemson, Clough to the left, and Parker. Oh, Clough! He gets there, he scores! And the long wait is over for Nigel Clough. And how pleased they are here that he was past fit this morning. Jemson set it up, and Tottenham couldn't trap him, really, as they moved towards the ball. That pass got through, Clough got through, and Torstvedt couldn't get out quickly enough. First blood to Forrest. Jemson. Hodge was a little too eager then, but the ball caught up with him. Parker. Oh, and it's Roy Keane off the bar. And back by nine to a goalkeeper. Torstvedt uses it straight away. Here come Tottenham. An incident totally in keeping with this marvellous match. It was Gary Parker's pass that was chased by Keane on the stretch, everything but the goal. Gascoigne couldn't trip Keane. Well, Roy Keane, who's been pretty close to Paul Gascoigne when Tottenham have had the ball. But when Forrest got away a few minutes ago, where was Gascoigne when Keane hit the bar, you might ask? Hodge. Four up for Forrest. Four back for Tottenham. Jemson, brilliant ball from Hodge. A clear chance. And Jemson angry with himself. Well, Stewart could have made it 1-1, just as Jemson here could have made it 2-0. Stewart, the flag has stayed down. Is this the equaliser? No. Allen might get it, though. Crossley gave Paul Stewart very little to shoot at. And Forrest were caught square. Allen. It's a great spell for Spurs, but Lineker in another if-only situation. Gascoigne. Stewart. Howells! It had to come. It had to come. We're midway through the second half, a second half that Tottenham have taken by the scruff of its neck. And Stewart and Gascoigne this time weren't initially able to apply any finesse. It was sheer force that got the ball to Howells, who banged it wide of Crossley. Walker thinking about attack. Jemson. And Des Walker, who's never scored for Forest, can he do it now? Torsvet's out of position, Crosby's got the ball, the goal is open, and it's blocked by Howells, who looks as though he's been a saviour now in two senses, in scoring the Tottenham equaliser and in getting back on his own goal line to prevent Forest picking up a victory in the closing seconds. Well, an amazing end to an amazing game. The scoreline does scant justice to it. Walsh, Lineker, headed behind by Pearce. Torsvet having to kick away from Des Walker and then left stranded, but David Howells with a wonderful rescue for Tottenham. Oh, it's Howells again! What a hero! What a game he's had! Two goals! He's won it surely for Terry Venables, and he prevented Forrest from winning it a moment or two ago. Swung himself at it. Next stop, back of the net.
Well, David, that was some game, wasn't it?
Oh, it was a great game, yes. Yeah, really quick, and the passing from both teams was good, and I think everybody enjoyed it.
Now, did you know that Brian Clough was celebrating 25 years as a manager?
No, I didn't actually. No. Only when I read it in the papers the following day.
I saw him after the match and he didn't look very pleased with you, but it must have been marvellous to score that winning goal just the last minute.
Yeah, it's a great feeling. It's the first time I've ever got two in a game, and for it to be right in the last minute when there's no chance of them getting back in the game, it's just a great feeling.
Well, the thing that staggered me was the save on the goal line, what, seconds before you scored?
Yeah, I panicked a bit then. I was expecting Crosby to chip me, and he drilled it in quite low and it bounced just in front of me, and I was just concerned with getting everything behind it, and then I slipped as I was trying to get back up, but I just scrambled it away.
Well, that's all it needed doing. Then, I can't quite remember, did you dash right up and go right into the penalty area for the corner?
More or less, yeah. I think it was from that attack, I think the ball got played back to Eric and then we won a corner. And I was debating whether to go up, and myself and Mabsy decided to go up for it. And, well, it's all right.
Well, it was a super header anyway. But now the first goal, it was rather a miracle the ball got you, because Gazza fell down and then Stewart almost fell over Gazza.
Yeah, it was a bit of a scramble, wasn't it? But, it seemed like I was waiting on the edge of the box for quite a long time. I just had a feeling the ball was going to come out to me. And I was not sure whether to go in there and try and win it, but luckily it fell to me.
Spurs still unbeaten, along with Palace, Arsenal and Liverpool. Liverpool dropping their first points of the season the preceding weekend at Norwich. The following Tuesday, Bradford City were the visitors in the third round of the Rumbelows League Cup.
It's a corner though to Bradford. We've got some defending to do here. And it's Oliver has scored! And that is a real shock. The supporters who have made the journey down from Yorkshire are quite naturally delighted. And the header from Oliver. Bradford City have the lead. But now, what can Gascoigne do about that? What can Gascoigne do about that? Well, he's given his answer in the best possible fashion with a quite stunning goal. Well, we're almost growing used to seeing that kind of virtuosity from Gazza. No another brilliant goal. He scored four against Hartlepool in the second round. Still got some defending to do. John Doherty, the new Bradford manager, has instilled some fight into his side. But now, here comes Paul Allen. Lineker, back for Allen. Stewart! Another goal of great simplicity. And Paul Stewart, who's found it so difficult to score in the league this season, has now been on the mark in the Rumbelows Cup three times.
The next game will provide the sternest test. Liverpool, undefeated in the league since last March, when Spurs beat them 1-0.
Beardsley. Rush. Albee. Staunton. Towards Burrows, just making it back for McMahon. A bit of space out here now for Nicol. Suddenly the red shirts are coming forward. There are four of them up there now, supporting Steve Nicol. One of them, Jan Molby. A little chip there towards Rush. And Liverpool have scored a goal. They came, we thought, to defend. We feared for Tottenham on the breakaway. It was almost in slow motion there. We were looking around to see whether there was an infringement somewhere almost, but a lovely little bit of play again by Molby, saying about his passing. Now what about that? Perfect. A rush, a flick over Torstvedt, and Liverpool in the lead. Beardsley. Molby. Burrows. It's a lovely little ball in! It's another one for Rush!
Oh, no argument.
A terrific strike by Liverpool. Coming in the first place from an unlikely quarter with Dave Burrows making his run. And what a great ball in here. Inviting Rush, an invitation he accepted with his usual style. It's a good free kick by Gascoigne, though, and it had Nicol at full stretch to get it away. Mitchell Thomas turning it back in once more. Howell didn't get a touch to it. Howell against the post. Lineker! And Spurs are back in business.
Well, it's certainly warmed up now.
We saw the two sides of Paul Gascoigne there. I mean, it was stupid the way he hit the ball at Rush there, but then he floated in this magical free kick. Howell's hit the post. It rebounds then to Lineker. Bobolar couldn't hold it, and it's 2-1 now to Liverpool.
Tottenham got the bit of luck they needed there because the ball, it was a great effort that hit the post. And fortunately for Tottenham, it came back to Gary Lineker.
Tottenham free kick by Hussein, quickly taken by Walsh and cut out well by Ablett just when it looked as though Howell's ball might go through to Lineker. Now Ablett, Lineker up, or rather Beardsley up alongside him, and so too is Rush. It's there for Beardsley!
Well, that's a great move.
Fantastic run by Peter Beardsley. And a great breakaway goal by Liverpool. Ablett's part in it was magnificent.
Good cross by Rush.
It's been a busy week for the Paul Gascoigne publicity machine. His new singles in the top 10 and a trip to the West End to turn on the Christmas lights. On the field, Gazza's 10th minute corner caught the Dons napping. Gave Paul Stewart a chance to score his first league goal of the season. Fifteen minutes later, though, it's Gascoigne, the villain. It's Spurs can't get it away, and watch for a careless back pass there. It lets in Alan Cork, and Erik Thorsved has no chance. Wimbledon a level. That mistake lit up increasingly confident Wimbledon, and watch for a stunning effort from Paul McGee. Again, Thorsved given no chance. Wimbledon with a great record in recent years at White Hart Lane, but Spurs level just before half-time. Identical goal. Gascoigne, Stewart on the near post, and Gary Mabbott, the skipper, 2-2 at half-time. Well, the second half was all one-way traffic. It all went Spurs' way, but it looked as though Wimbledon would hold out for a draw until the last 5 minutes. Paul Walsh, the substitute, so quick on the near post, and that's 3-2. And then Spurs made absolutely certain. Naheem sent tumbling, a definite penalty, and Gary Lineker, who had a superb match, made it 4-2. A cracking, entertaining game.
Lineker, look at the space on Lineker there. The Everton fans reacted probably quicker than that to that situation than the players themselves. A great groan went up as Nicol was seen to be in as much space as that. Here's McCall. Dummy by Sharp, gets it back from Cotty. Plays it now for Eberl. That's a good little cross turn to McCall. Season, but it was a great move. Sharp and Cotty involved, and then the ball out to Eberl. There's the Sharp and Cotty touch. Here's Eberl's beautiful cross, and McCall on the far side with a downward header. Fiona at the near post along with Sharp. Eberl tried to make something of it. There were too many white shirts there. Gascoigne got caught just for a moment. Sharp now! And a terrific save by Thorsved. Well, it broke beautifully for Graham Sharp. Clear of the last line of defenders, but Thorsved stood big and strong and made a really excellent save. We'll look at that again in a moment. But here's another corner for Everton. And a good safe catch by the big Norwegian. What about this for a save, Laurie?
We closed him down well, didn't he? Broke nicely. He's already coming off his line, you see, and he doesn't get the much of the goal.
Mack van den Hauw. Stewart again, arms raised on the far side there, wanting the cross in. Here's Lineker. Gascoigne. There's Lineker again. About to say Everton won't mind if he stays on the touchline, but Lineker's always likely to look for the pass coming in, and it's a lovely goal scored by Howells. And Spurs go 1-1. To the delight of their travelling fans, Lineker's David Howells, fourth of the season. Sorry, Laurie.
Lineker went pretty deep there, and I think they lost that concentration a bit, and Howells just nipped in there on the back. A little bit of ball watching. You see, you can sometimes get too many defenders back there and no one is really picking up.
So that first loss of the season against Liverpool, but 4 points gained from the win over Wimbledon and the draw at Everton. Liverpool, though, 11 points above Spurs already.
One of the snags for both of you is that you've only lost once this season, but I see you're 11 points behind Liverpool. What on earth can we do about this Liverpool side?
Well, obviously, they're a tremendous side. They keep it simple. And I think we've got to forget about Liverpool and concentrate on ourselves. And we've got to keep winning as many games as we can to catch them.
What about you, Paul? How did you feel you could catch them?
Oh, sure. I agree with really 100% what Mitchell says. They're a very good side. But I think we've got to concentrate on what we're doing and what we're doing well. And we had a very good run in the end of last season after Christmas. And if we can play like that, then, you know, we've got to have a chance, I think.
Still in the league, Norwich provided the next opposition at White Hart Lane.
Another difficult week off the pitch for Tottenham. Manager Terry Venables rumoured to be mulling over a move back to Spain, this time to take charge of Real Madrid. His contract at Spurs expires at the end of the season. But in the meantime, with the results in the league continuing to go his way, there are worse places to be than White Hart Lane. Gary Lineker kept the Tottenham bandwagon rolling, his early strike carrying the suspicion of handball. Certainly the Norwich defenders thought they spotted a touch of the Maradona's. Handball possibly there from Paul Stewart as well. And did Lineker help it through with his left hand? But it was Ian Crook, a former Spurs player himself, who put Norwich back on level terms. A curling free kick eluding the diving Eric Torsford, Norwich are beginning to find their range in front of goal. This is, however, a more resilient Tottenham side. Paul Stewart, despite scoring just one goal in the league this season, is beginning to look the part, and his nod down to Gary Lineker helped give Spurs the vital breakthrough that keeps them in touch at the top of the First Division.
Another league win, but would the cup success continue? The Rumbelows League competition was next, Tottenham travelling to Sheffield United.
And again, Walsh doing well for Spurs by challenging back and winning the ball and tricking his way past the first defender, Wilder. The cross is towards Stewart inside the area, Paul Stewart. Spurs are in front. And Paul Stewart keeps his run going in the Rumbelows Cup. And he will be the first to say, well done to Paul Walsh too. He challenged back for it, he won it, he swung it in. Stewart burst between the two defenders and the merest touch took it over Tracy and into the Sheffield net. Gascoigne riding the challenges, giving it, and there's danger here. Stewart through the middle, Walsh is there too. Walsh, they look for an offside, it wasn't forthcoming. This could clinch it. Walsh, the save is there, but surely now it's 2-0 and Gazza's got it. He raises his arms aloft. The crowd here have given him a lot of stick tonight, but he was in the right place at the right time to make sure that Spurs go through to the next round of the Rumbelows Cup. Again, the substitute Walsh involved. Tracy could do no more than palm it out. Lineker couldn't get there. Gascoigne could.
4 days later, Spurs away again at Chelsea in the league.
It's been a very good week for Chelsea fan John Major, but the new PM was not at Stamford Bridge. He missed a great game. 5 minutes gone, Andy Townsend's pass. Kerry Dixon beats young defender David Tuttle. The 18-year-old Tuttle making his debut in place of the injured Steve Sedgley, finding first-team life pretty hard. Gary Lineker. The goal won't count. He used his arm to control it, and not much doubt about it when we look at it as he battles past Moncal. Dennis Wise cost over £1.5 million from Wimbledon. He creates Chelsea's second just before half-time. Dury's volley is blocked. Bumstead, assigned to Mark Gascoigne, pops up to score. 10 minutes into the second half, Mabbott brought down by Moncal. A free kick, always dangerous when Paul Gascoigne is around. His speciality, his 12th goal of the season. Just 2 minutes later, corner from Wise. Mitchell Thomas tries to get it away. Only as far as Gordon Dury. What a good volley. 3-1 to Chelsea. 60 seconds later, Naheem. Lineker against Dave Besant, and that's a definite penalty. Lineker normally doesn't miss from here. Remember the World Cup? A rare miss, though, from the England skipper. Now, Lineker celebrated his 30th birthday on Friday, and he gets a little present now. Paul Stewart allowed a couple of bites at the cherry, and Lineker with a good finish. But Chelsea win 3-2. They're still unbeaten at home. As for Spurs, it's their first away defeat. Against Sunderland, Venables' side seemed unable to shake the continuing bad news out of their system. Colin Pascoe, who hadn't scored for a year, put the Wearsiders one up after just 10 minutes. Gordon Armstrong shot, Thorsved pushes it out, and a simple tap-in for Pascoe. Ten minutes later, Spurs' week was assuming crisis proportions. Now, Peter Davenport's been in splendid form this season. There's a neat 1-2 played and a fine finish from Davenport. Spurs 2 down and looking at their second successive league defeat.
too much for referee Ian Henley. He limped out of the game with a calf injury, and within a minute, his replacement, Mike Alexander, was the least popular man at White Hart Lane. There's a powerful header from David Howells. It's disallowed, though, presumably for offside against Lineker. The Spurs players not happy about it. Paul Walsh was introduced in the second half to immediate effect. Howell's free kick and number five of the season for Paul Walsh. What a handy man to have on the bench. Just 5 minutes later, Walsh is at it again. This is Howells on the near side. Walsh again, big deflection, and Spurs are level. Just as we look at it again, the deflection comes off Gary Hours, and poor Tony Norman in the Sunderland goal has no chance. Well, Spurs now look to be in complete command, but as so often happens, they left themselves open at the back. Some brilliant work there by Marco Gabbiadini, and Pasco is in for his second. Sunderland 3-2 up. A great game, this one at White Hart Lane, and a sting in the tail as well. Paul Walsh, so much involved, and the England skipper, Gary Lineker, heads the equaliser. 3-3. What a great match.
Five minutes gone at Main Road. Manchester City 0, Tottenham Hotspur 0. Gascoigne. Still Gascoigne for Tottenham. It's a goal that Manchester City claim shouldn't stand because of a handball. But from Gascoigne's point of view, another marvellous solo effort. With a little bit of help along the way, he got past Reid, came back off the knee, and it seemed to be taken on Gascoigne's chest, and he made the rest look ridiculously simple when of course it wasn't. Manchester City are behind. Knee, chest, it was the second one they were appealing for. John Key says goal. Manchester City still coming on strong, but still trailing for the Gascoigne goal. Oh, Clark! And it finally went in off Redmond. 1-1. White sweeping it wide for Ward. Tottenham back pedal. Mark Ward goes for goal. Niall Quinn looks for goal. Appeals for handball, not given. Megson. Reid. Right, well, was that handball? The referee points after some thought. Tottenham go to him with their protests. The first one was turned down, and I'm sure rightly so. And then City kept on working. And Reid just slipped it wide here for Brightwell. Vanden Howe and Walsh went across. He scores! Manchester City 2, Tottenham Hotspur 1.
The worst run of the season so far, only 1 point from 3 games, and Spurs dropped to fourth, 11 points behind Liverpool. Coming up, the Christmas and New Year fixtures, starting at home to Luton Town. Spurs have been struggling recently, just 1 point from the last 3 games, and Luton seem right on course to add to the misery. 12 minutes gone, Kingsley Black with the cross, and Ian Dowie, the Northern Ireland striker, completing an all-Irish move. Naheem didn't help the Tottenham cause, sent off for dissent midway through the first half. A Spurs down to 10 men then, but when Paul Gascoigne's one of them, it doesn't matter. Gascoigne this week named BBC Sports Personality of the Year, and he wriggles through the Luton defence typically. And Paul Stewart reaps the rewards. Just the second goal of the season for Stewart. Bad-tempered game this one. 4 bookings and 3 sendings off. Pat Vandenhauer joined Naheem in the dressing room, and Luton's Kerry Hughes also giving his marching orders after a foul on Lineker. Just before the hour, though, the same combination. Gascoigne with the corner and Stewart with the strike. Spurs finish with 9 men, but all 3 points.
Coventry faltering under new manager Terry Butcher, but the Sky Blues always enjoy playing Spurs, who could forget their FA Cup final triumph 3 years ago. And sure enough, they regained winning ways. Kevin Gallagher with the first, his 10th goal of the season. He's justifying that record £900,000 transfer fee. Tottenham, according to manager Terry Venables, fell apart after that. Eric Torsvet unable to claim the ball on the edge of the area. Mickey Ginn making absolutely sure of the points for Coventry. Their first win under Terry Butcher, and another body blow to Tottenham's title hopes.
Liverpool and Arsenal are thought to be pursuing the prolific young Southampton striker Matthew Letizier, and another stunning performance at the Dell won't have lowered the asking price. Spurs were this week's victims, Letizier latching onto a speculative through ball for his first of the afternoon. Spurs' title challenge seems to have sunk without trace over the Christmas holiday, and without Paul Gascoigne, who was sick, they were short of creativity in midfield. The defence wasn't too clever either. Rodney Wallace volleying home a poor clearance. And yet another defensive tangle put the Londoners in even more trouble. The ball once again bounced kindly for Letizier to scramble home his 13th goal of the season. It was a torrid afternoon for Tottenham, and it's back to the drawing board for Terry Venables, while Letizier can just sit and wait for the offers to come flooding in.
Good jump by Howells. What a good header.
And here's Stewart. Lineker's waiting in the middle for him. And did he cross the line?
Well, I have to say, I thought it did. I thought it was in.
But it was touch and go, and the linesman was standing right by the corner flag, and the referee has pointed to the corner. Stewart making the break, and it just clipped off the goalkeeper, and they say it didn't cross the line. Paul Allen now trying to rattle one in there.
He's given a penalty.
And he's given a penalty. Well, it must have been a foul on Allen.
I think it was for a handball. He's given it. He's indicating it was a handball.
At any rate, it's Lineker. 11 goals this season, but only one from the penalty spot. And he missed against Chelsea from the spot, remember, a few weeks back. Lineker. 1-0 to Tottenham.
Getting in quickly, but United keep possession. Webb spraying the long ball forward now, sensing possibly that Sharp might have the measure of Mitchell Thomas.
I think he has got the measure of him by now. He's very pacey, Sharp.
Blackmore playing it in. Hughes, was he pushed down? It's going to be a penalty by Van den Hout.
That looked a clearer penalty than the one at the other end. And it gives United now the chance of coming back to 1-1. Three penalties in the last two games. Steve Bruce now with a chance of making it 1-1 and succeeds in doing so.
Yeah, he went goalkeeper's left again.
Oh, good play by Paul Stewart.
Gascoigne away on the right. Played in quickly by him towards Lineker. And Spurs claiming there was a foul on Lineker as that ball went screeching across that six-yard area. But the referee wanting none of it. And in fact, I think Gascoigne may have protested a little too loudly. Here we are again. They claim there was a foul on Lineker. Didn't look it to me. And Gascoigne for dissent. We'll get a red card. He must have said something to the referee there that required an instant red card. Paul Gascoigne sent off.
Well, that is amazing, really. Obviously, as you say, he must have said something, called the referee something that he thought, well, I'm not having you on the field. same things like that. It must be.
Martin. Webb. Can he open the door? Bruce. Did he score from the penalty spots? Up there towards Hughes. Might come from Leclerc. United have snatched it.
Three defeats in a row and the league position suffers. The chances of a championship now slim. Limpar. Fennec. Now Thomas. Lovely touch from Gascoigne. It's a great move from Tottenham. Has it produced the goal? No. Lineker and Gascoigne. And it's no exaggeration to say that that was world class. Touch off by Gascoigne. Lineker instantly rolled it through. It was a great pass. And Gascoigne couldn't find the shot that he was looking for inside the post. Howells trying to drop it over the top for Lineker. He's done just that. Gary Lineker. David Seaman just got part of his body to it. Mitchell Thomas. Really has been nothing between the sides in the second half, but now Lineker for Tottenham and David O'Leary with some heroic defending for Arsenal. Lineker can retrieve it on the right. Allen! Allen has got Walsh to his right. Lineker is the only other player up for Spurs. And Walsh gets past Davis and plays Paul Allen in for Spurs, and Seaman was allowed to make the save. Some 90 seconds plus stoppage time. Nice dummy by Lineker. Here's Walsh. He's got Lineker up with him. And Seaman yet again. Gary Lineker had better fortune against Derby County in the following league match at the baseball ground. His 13th goal of the season, not exactly a classic, but good enough to get the better of his boyhood idol and his old England roommate, Peter Shilton. And it was enough to provide the 3 points for Tottenham. The first league win in 5 games, and Spurs now in 6th place. But a new team atop of the table, for the first time in over 12 months, Arsenal overhaul Liverpool. In the Rumbelows League Cup 5th round tie at Chelsea, only excellent goalkeeping from Erik Thorstvedt kept Spurs' hopes alive in a match where the suspended Paul Gascoigne was sorely missed. The replay went all Chelsea's way. Already a goal up from Andy Townsend when Kerry Dixon put his mark on the tie.
Matthew, Townsend, against the post. Can Dixon get there first? He has! It's a second one for Chelsea.
A Dennis Wise penalty wrapped up an impressive 3-0 win for Chelsea.
The match at White Hart Lane had already been deprived of Spurs' Paul Gascoigne and David Batty, Leeds' own midfield dynamo. Just 2 minutes into the game, the Yorkshire side's top scorer, Lee Chapman, collapsed on the touchline after a challenge with Steve Sedgley. Chapman received a nasty cut after crashing down on the cinders. For a while it looked serious, but thankfully, after several minutes, he was able to walk away. But not a pretty sight. His presence might have lifted an otherwise drab encounter. Leeds had the better of the action, but all too often their attacks broke down too far from the danger zone for tottering Tottenham. Alan Williams might have made more of this effort.
An afternoon best forgotten at Wimbledon, Gudni Bergsson, the Spurs scorer. Then a chance for Rumbelow's Cup revenge at home to Chelsea.
Chelsea go ahead after 20 minutes at White Hart Lane. Dennis Wise with the corner, Kerry Dixon flicks on, and it's Gordon Jury collecting his 11th of the season. Spurs manage to salvage something from this one. Gary Lineker, latching on to Edinburgh's long ball, is brought down by Dave Besant just before half-time. Lineker himself earns Tottenham a draw from the spot, but Spurs have won just 1 of their last 8 league games. Tottenham's difficulties continue, financial matters unresolved. Worse still, Paul Gascoigne appears to be on his way to Italy. but it was fellow World Cup hero David Platt who steals the show with a hat-trick. Gordon Cowans lays on the pass, and Platt shows beautiful control. His 17th of the season. Villa, now battling for survival in the First Division, will be glad he's back. Cowans again the provider for Platt's second after 35 minutes. Poor marking leaves Torsford offering only token resistance, but wonderful first touch again from Platt. The hat-trick came a minute after the break. The corner is cleared. Trinidad international Dwight York knocks the ball forward. And there is the predatory Platt, happily restored to fitness. It's 3-0 to Villa. Gascoigne, of course, missing after his stomach operation this week. But his replacement, Vinnie Samway, seizes on a great cross from young substitute Philip Gray to offer Spurs a ray of hope. If Gascoigne does go, then Samways could be an important player at White Hart Lane. Paul Allen restored some respectability, adding a goal 7 minutes from time, although Nigel Spink probably feels he should have stopped it. But it was too little, too late for troubled Tottenham.
White Hart Lane, Gary Lineker makes his 300th league appearance. On this occasion, though, his goal touch deserts him. In the second half, Spurs claim they should have had a penalty. Walsh down and Naheem down as well. Play on, says the referee. Rangers, in fact, rather unfortunate not to get all 3 points. Wegerle springs the offside trap. Simon Barker's effort, well saved by Erik Torsved. 3 minutes later, Barker beats Torsved. This time the post's in the way. On the field, Spurs without two star prize assets, Gascoigne and Lineker. Coventry take full advantage. They go two up in 19 minutes. That's David Smith's first of the season. And Coventry City really dominate the match early on. Tottenham all over the place, particularly in defence. Cyril Regis with an excellent header off the post. Coventry's second has to come, though. And indeed it does. And the scorer is Kevin Gallagher. Again, poor defending, and Gallagher takes full advantage. Good finish from the Scot. So Coventry looking set for only their second away win of the season, but 2 minutes before half-time and against the run of play, Spurs are back in it. And a good finish too from the Spaniard, Naheem. Two-one at half-time. And the Spurs boss, Terry Venables, clearly has words with his side, and they raise the pace and quality of their game in the second half. Walsh doing exceptionally well here, and when he floats the ball in, Naheem is there for his second and the Spurs equaliser. On the plastic pitch, still problems for both Spurs and Luton. Neither side really impressing. Luton, though, coming closest to scoring. There's a penalty, Samway stripping Mark Pembridge. And the Luton skipper, John Dreyer, has an excellent record from the spot this season. He hasn't missed one, he has now. Worst to follow for Luton, fullback Marvin Johnson sent off for his second bookable offence after 72 minutes. The Luton fans calling for their chairman to be sacked, and the side is still deep in relegation trouble. White Hart Lane, Gary Lineker back for Spurs after an Easter break. He'd been rested after complaining of feeling tired. He looks sharp enough here, 38 minutes gone. The England man doing what he does best. He does it again 3 minutes later. Vandenhuis pass, Lineker through, one-on-one with Tim Flowers in the Southampton goal, and Lineker gets the better of it once again. It doesn't go all Lineker's way, though. In the second half, he has the chance for a hat-trick from the penalty spot. Flowers saves well. Spurs and Lineker, though, on song for next week's FA Cup semi-final with Arsenal. And Carrow
Road, all eyes on Paul Gascoigne. The Spurs boss, Terry Venables, taking a gamble on Gazza's fitness before the FA Cup semi-final against Arsenal. Just 4 weeks after a double hernia operation, Gazza, skipper for the night, is back to his best. But the Spurs manager had rested half his first-team regulars with that cup match very much in mind. So, not all that surprising when Norwich take the lead on 12 minutes. Fine work here by Dale Gordon. And finally, David Phillips cuts it back for Lee Power to open the scoring. That's Power's third of the season. Just before half-time, Gazza right in the thick of it as Spurs get their equaliser. Gascoigne for Naheem, and the Moroccan's cross is flicked on by Paul Walsh for the young Scot John Hendry. And Hendry beats Brian Gunn. It's his Spurs debut. A fine way to mark that. Norwich, though, take the points. 9 minutes to go, and a superb effort from Ian Crook. In off the crossbar, and Ian Crook, of course, a former Tottenham player. Just one early goal settles this one at Selhurst Park. Thorsved challenged, can't hold it. Eric Young hooks it in for the only goal of the game. Spurs back down to earth after that semi-final success. Well, Sheffield United made sure of their First Division future last week, and perhaps a bit of complacency creeping in. They go two down to Spurs at Bramall Lane. Cross from Paul Stewart, and Justin Edinburgh hammers it in. The young fullback's first goal for Spurs on 67 minutes. 5 minutes later, Spurs go two up. They break free from their own area. That's Vinny Samways in the clear. Just one defender facing him. Samways hits the bar, and Walsh is first to the rebound. 2-0 Spurs. And now United get their act together and they stage a remarkable comeback. Just 12 minutes to go, Paul Beasley heads home. And Dave Bassett's side confirm what great fighting spirit they have. The last minute of the game here. Brian Dean past Torsved. Dean celebrates his call up to the England B squad. Spurs are without Paul Gascoigne against Everton, and they go behind early on. Robert Varshika's cross, Martin Keown hits the bar, and Pat Nevin nods in the rebound. Everton the goal up, just 5 minutes played. 4 minutes later, the Spurs equaliser. The young fullback Justin Edinburgh with a good cross. Hinchcliffe and Southall in all sorts of bother. Paul Allen heads the equaliser, 1-1 at half-time. 3 minutes after the break, Everton in front once again, thanks to an own goal. Well, Paul Stewart hasn't scored in his last 16 matches for Spurs. He scores this time for Everton, though. Cross from Beagrie and deflected past Torsved by the unfortunate Stewart. But that's followed by a brilliant Spurs equaliser. Corner from Naheem, and watch this volley from the skipper, Gary Mabbott. 2-2, 64 minutes played. Smashing goal. A real topsy-turvy game, this one. 7 minutes later, Everton are back in front. Eric Torsved in the Spurs goal at fault. Pushes Hinchcliffe's shot against the bar, and Tony Coddy bundles the ball over the line. Everton hoping for the first win at White Hart Lane in 6 visits, but it's Spurs who have the last word. Another great goal as well. Watch for Naheem, the Moroccan-born Spaniard, picking it up wide there on the left, cuts inside, and a great curler beyond Neville Southall. Paul Gascoigne back for Spurs in this dress rehearsal for the FA Cup final against Nottingham Forest. But Forest, 16 goals in the last 3 games, get the better of the first half. That's a rare mistake from Gary Mabbott, and a superb finish from Nigel Clough. Number 17 of the season for the manager's son. We know Paul Gascoigne has quite a way with free kicks, and he sets up the Spurs equaliser. It's scored by Naheem. So, 1-1 at White Hart Lane, but they'll have to be a winner at Wembley in the FA Cup final.
Well, Graham Souness is hoping to bring fresh faces to Anfield next season after losing the championship to Arsenal. Could mean an end-of-season clear out at Liverpool. Pretty safe bet, though, that Ian Rush will still be around. His goal puts Liverpool ahead against Spurs just before half-time. Spurs, with their minds on the FA Cup final against Forest next Saturday, no surprise, really, when Liverpool go two up. Ray Houghton's cross finds David Speedy in space. Liverpool finished the season on a high. Spurs, without a win in their last five games, going to Wembley. Now Lineker. Hendry getting into the centre. Here he is! Well, it was a nice link-up between Gary Lineker and his young striking helper tonight, John Hendry. And Hendry was saying, put it there. And in fact, Lineker couldn't quite put it where Hendry wanted it. Samways. It is a quite amazing night here in the way that the crowd has turned out to pay tribute to both sides, really. And they think they're going to see a penalty. And the referee, Watson, says no. And he was right on the spot. Well, earlier in the season, if this match had been played, I think there might have been a few United protests, but the game goes on with Ince. It's a goal! Deflected off Terry Fenwick. Poor Fenwick, who broke his leg here early last season, has had some more bad fortune, but Paul Ince will want to claim the goal because it will be his first for Manchester United at Old Trafford. Hendry. Here's Stewart. Well, Robson's showing you've got to tackle the former Manchester City players even in a game like this. Good turn by Hendry. Now Samway is getting the better of Pallister. If he slips it to Hendry now, it must be a goal, and he just delayed it too long and Phelan got back. Well, Tottenham so close to an equaliser. Irwin. McClare is free! And Torstvedt watched it. And happily for him, it sailed wide of the goal. But there won't be too many prizes tonight for tight marking. Hendry. Samways. Now Lineker. Oh, there's a mistake by Robson, who's due to start his holiday tomorrow and might just have let his mind wander then. Hendry! 1-1, and John Hendry, who scored for Tottenham a couple of months ago at Norwich on his debut, shows the depth in the ranks at White Hart Lane with another fine goal here at Old Trafford. Lovely looping header. A final placing of 10th, the league season falling apart around Christmas, but the First Division lack of form made up for by the wonderful success in the FA Cup.